Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the saga. RedMcNed, in case you forgot. I almost forgot that we are not done here yet. A lot of it got finished, but there's still like the interior and the exterior on top. Spent so much time on the bottom, forgot to look at the top. So we're going to be spending time around this general kind of up high area because I want to get a path going up this also. I want a path that goes up this, and I want not down here. I want to get a courtyard going too, and to fix up these walls, get them looking better. So I've got about half the project done. This is what it looked like before, like meh, gray, whatever. And this is a little better. It's a layer of dirt that's just on top of the bricks, like those. But this is still kind of dreary. So what I'm gonna do is kind of plant some seeds of greenness. So I, with my silk touch shovel, this side here, just putting a little, bits of encouragement on the ground. Ha ha! Ha ha! Yes, there it is. So, as you can see, green is contagious. And if I put just a couple of these in there, before I know it, it'll all be nice and green. So, I'm gonna fill in this side and do the same thing, and then we'll go from there. Also, a bit of an extra word. If I did my part, you can't tell. Or if I did my job, you can't tell. But I actually don't have the same microphone today. I left my headset at a friend's house this weekend, so I'm actually having to use a better quality microphone that I have lying around. Think about it, I don't know why I don't have it usually going on. Like, depending on how this works out, I might just stick with this. Because, for one thing, it might actually be better quality. Another thing is it actually has, like, a wind muff or a pop filter on it, so I go pop, 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 pop. Puh, puh. And hopefully it doesn't like go like ow, 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 like into your ears. But also, I think it frees up some space on my computer because it struggles just to make these videos. So if I have the audio on a separate file than the video, think of all the cool stuff I could do. Or just normal stuff. I could just do normal stuff better. Little update. It's been about 4 minutes, and look at that. It's already taking over. The next part is gonna be looking at those walls. So remember what we did for the walkways? I'll show you so you don't even have to remember. I put the torches along the sides here, along these really typical looking. And remember, since it was even, I had to kinda, do this in the middle. But set one down, these half slabs, or a half a step down, whatever. Just whatever this looks like, this is what I'm trying to explain. I'm gonna be doing that along this pathway. There's gonna be kind of an interesting thing in the middle, but it'll have that kind of standard wall type thing, a little bridge right there. And I'll do a little bit and I'll show you what I mean. Oh yes, it's spreading nicely. Like some kind of infectious disease. Well, here's the halfway done view. And that's actually really good because we can look at the fact that this is why I do the torches on every one of these. Is you get a really even looking thing here. Where over here it's sort of like, whoa, you know, I don't want woes. At least not that kind. You can see it going on better on these too. I kind of like that. It's nice and regular, suffice it to say. So I decided to go completely half because, like I said, it was half, and I wanted to be a smarty pants. So this is what one side looks like. This is the before. Yes. Okay. Good. Good indeed. Well, and this is this side. And oh yeah, there's a stairway. Oh, okay. The floor. Ooh, this looks interesting. I wonder what that is. And let's just pretend it keeps going forever. And oh, I thought I heard something magical. Oh, maybe I do. Maybe I do. Oh, if I can operate a staircase, you know, that's difficult. So on each of the corners, I want to put one of these. Nice little flame tower. It's a little bit hold on. Gotta figure out what I'm gonna say. Oh, I kind of like having the fire in the corners, 'cause it's like there's these torches around to light it up, and then there's like a big torch or whatever, like a thing. And like maybe if people were like, "Oh no, they're attacking the castle. I gotta get a flaming arrow, but I don't know how I'll ever do that. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know." And so they could like run around the fire until they realize that the fire's on fire, you know. And if there was no fire there, then there would be no running around the fire and finding out what's on fire. And there's a little bit of a bridge thing here. I kind of liked how this was going. It's just sort of a oh, an archway to sort of make it seem, you know, anything that makes it seem more depthy and cool, but doesn't really block that view up there either. So I'm gonna show you just roughly how I did all that. One thing I did was I took half slabs just to save on resources and monies. So that by the time you're done, you're like, this doesn't look any different than a normal block. But secret, secret, you know. And same with the roof, only on a like a halfway down sort of thing. I put the staircase actually going along here with these. So these actually can't go here. But I think I put at least two of those there, yeah. And then the rest is just like that. In fact, everywhere where there's an opening, these get to go down, just, you know. Everywhere. The middle, though, special. And if you have this, you can light it up! And that's the first start. Whoa. That's the first start of the beacon. Now, because of safety reasons and relegation, yeah, you gotta make sure no one trips and falls their head into that specifically. So I'm gonna run out of these soon. Oh, I almost forgot my manners. I should, every time there's like a corner thing, I went ahead and put these on them. And since this is a even number in the middle, the only thing, never mind the random, you know, impossible stunts like the crazy spins. It's just it happens. Nothing I can do about it. So, but for the middle, I just put two of those next to each other. So there's that. Luckily, the dimensions are a little bit friendlier over here. It's just every other one. And you get to include the corners too. The corners. The bridge, though. I actually have to look at it from both sides. Alright, so it's regular flat up to there. So, let's see if I can do this right. Regular flat. Oh, wait, not regular flat. Hold on. Alright, it's gotta be the same level here. And it kind of goes up a half step each block it goes over. Just a very smooth transition going up. And it's exactly the same on the side, too. So, reach to the bottom. Keep reaching. Do that to the other side. But each of these gets a one up. So that way it's like there's a little mini guardrail going on down there. And after that's all done and busted, you can do alternating all the way to the yay. I think I'd put these there too. Yeah, tweak this a little bit here. It's gonna be like a little bit of a. What is this even? Oh yeah, stone slab. A little squaring off of there. And I'll even do this there. So it's sort of like that. Of course, I didn't prepare. This is gonna be all these for the whole square. These stone slabs will then line up with the others down there. Put some more Neverrack in here. And whoa, light that on fire. Hopefully we're not standing in it. Block it up. Blocky, blocky, block. There we go. That's the thing. Oh, talk about good transitions. Next, we make a little support system down here. Because you know, you gotta support it. You can either put the stone slabs in there if you do or don't want to. It doesn't matter, and I'm not really gonna pay attention if you do or don't. So you can get away with not doing it. I'll just do a little bit of that. You know, it's the little things, you know? Just the little improvements. And speaking of little things, I also wanted to mention about those shadows being uniform up there. I don't actually need a torch on the backside of every one of those. In fact, if I just have every other one, the light will just go around the corner of both of these. You don't need a second one going around this corner. You already got one light source here. So you can actually skip one. This will light those two gaps. This one will light those two gaps. Etc. Etc. So, I think it's all a good improvement, good improvementation. The only thing I could also add is for this specific castle, I've had to start this block either on the corner or over here, and it couldn't be the same. Like, I'll go to that end really fast. Whoa, careful. I don't want to go in the fire. But see, I couldn't bring that all the way in. Apparently, all of these are either odd numbers or even in the wrong ways. They're either odd numbers or even in the wrong ways. Ah, stupid castle! I think that's good for now, just a little bit. There's definitely gonna have to be something else going on in here, some more things. But every little bit helps. And you don't have to do everything in one go. So little improvements here and there. That's all I need to do. And also, we have more important problems like, oh yeah, there's nothing here. This doesn't lead anywhere. So what I want to do is I usually come in from down there. Guess this demonstration is going to be in the rain. But I usually come in from here. And I feel like it's necessary to show this for because it's important information and also because science. This is where I come in. Generally, the reason why I want to show this is because I'm going to make a path up this thing. And I typically do something like this. Let's see. Whoa, 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 whoa. You know, I get dizzy on the side because, you know, heights make me dizzy. Do a little something like this. Yeah, that's kind of a cool view. I could either try to scale the wall this way or this way. Both are kind of tricky. Both require little jumps. And eventually, yeah, get to the top. So, I feel like if someone put their castle here, they would get sick of that journey. Where is it? There's the journey. And they would say, we spent so much time making a castle. Maybe we should make, like, I don't know, a road that leads to it, or a path, or something. Or something. So that's what we're gonna do. So these are a few supplies that'll probably try to help us out. A good thing to do is to start off by getting a grounding plan, or a plan for the grounding. And you might look at this and be like, I'm confused. Or you might listen to that last statement and say, I'm confused. And both are relatable. I can relate. It's not easy listening to a crazy person talk. Or looking at a mountainside and figuring out, well, what's the best way to go up it. So what you could do is you could either look at the way you usually go up the hill, or the path of least resistance, and try to go from there. The second part is go ahead and make little platforms along the way. Like, I'm gonna go ahead and take these out and say this, it looks like a nice spot to start from, and I'm gonna go this way. I'm gonna use these. It's a little bit easier to build going upward than downward, but for now, I'm just going to start and say this is where we descend from. We're gonna go that way. I think it's going to descend until it hits kinda here-ish. So what I'd want to do is make some kind of a platform here. Nothing too crazy or fancy, just, a little something. Next, I would have to f want to find the next spot. I think it's gonna wind along here and go there. So, what I would do is check out this area. I think what I'm going to do is take out these. In fact, I'm probably going to, let's see how much this I can take out. Think this could be a cool, looking at this before, whenever I climb the hill, I go up this, and this is a pretty nice little view, actually. I kind of like this. So I think I might make that a part of the path, like have it come up this way. And it's going to go around. I think that it should hug this wall. So I'm going to take out some of this. And the climb can start here-ish. I think I want to, have it close to the wall. Not too close, but close. Fairly close. So that's one spot. This is one spot. And it's gonna go up to there. So it's like finding these points. This would be another one. It has to find a way to get to here, which is gonna be kind of difficult. I might have to actually change the land around a little bit. So, get rid of some of this. And this can be a platform. And you know what? There's nothing wrong with carving down the side of the hill. So, I'm gonna have a little bit of that. So, it's gonna go straight along here. I can probably go into the hill a little bit, wherever it's not too inconvenient. I guess somewhere around here. You know what? This might end up being a switchback scenario. Because if this goes down to here, yeah, I might want it to make some switchbacks. Because, check it out. I want to have it go down to here, basically. I want to go along this path that we already talked and have it kind of go up this and start going up. But that is a bit steep to go up there all of a sudden. So maybe there's the road that I've carved. If we go this way, and then curve, and then down here, I think that'll look pretty cool. So I'm gonna get more of these little spots ready and see from there. So right now I've decided to build up, just kind of spamming the shovel every so often, then filling that in with this stuff. I'm trying to make a slope that's not too steep, but it is supposed to get up the mountain. I'm not going for any real super uniform setup. Just something that gets the job done. It actually doesn't have to look too good either, because most of this is supposed to be weathered. So there's a lot of forgiveness that comes with that. And let's see. So this is one of the platforms here. So I also like to have at least two squares in length per level change. So eventually you can make it a lot smoother if you want. This is pretty sudden, so I'm going to help it out. All right, yeah, I think that looks good. Throw some torches so nothing spawns on it. And there we go. That's the first part of the path. Nothing too fancy, but it's kind of fancy. Next is these jerk switchbacks here. What I'm gonna do is just go for it. I'm gonna go this way. Just every two forward, I go up one and try to make it three wide. And hope that like this isn't like super offensive to the to the path above. What I'm probably gonna do is make it wider, just in case, because I don't know how much room is actually up there, and I can build this up beneath it if I need to. So, by the way, when you're building in the rain, there's just something dramatic about it. I don't know. It's just it's just like this weird like you feel like, wow, this is really my survival depends on what I'm doing here, you know? Except I'm not making a shelter. That would probably be the only way to be cooler. Oh, really? Really? See, all the elements are against me right now. I just nothing's going my way, you know? All right, I can start turning this in. I don't have to go this way, actually. I want to meet up with this. Let's see, is there anywhere? Okay, so there's no path under that or under this, so I can work with it. See, I just want to try to keep the width about the same throughout this whole path, so that's why I'm bothering to take away bits of this mountain here. And I guess ultimately I want the floor to be mostly this material. This is gonna be an interesting spot. I sound like I'm indecisive, but that's just how I work. I work very indecisively. All right, this could be fine. I could do something like this. This goes around. I'm not worried about this sticking out this far because there's no path underneath it. I could put supports that just go straight down. Like I'm not worried about the underneath at all. This is all just the surface of the path itself, finding a way up the mountain. See that? This helps it come up. I guess I can worry about replacing these. And now we've made it to here. So we're halfway there. I think we can keep the three wide theme. Maybe even make it four wide, because this feels like an important bit right here. Or I can do like a sort of a gloved up, or a glove type. Eh, whatever, I'll do this. So it goes up this. And then the blah, the blah, the blah, blah. Oh, that works really good actually. So I got that. Comes up here. There's another checkpoint. Just building checkpoints. Go around here. Let's widen this. Didn't need that. Building up to there, so it's sort of going up at an angle now. I'm still trying to keep it wide. That might be too steep right there. Let's put it there. Put it there. Not an exact science. I don't know if I've said that, but that's why I like this actually, because they're kind of ruins. So you can kind of fudge around a little bit. So let's see, if the path is here, that means next path. Ooh, that's going to be, like, right on the edge. Maybe I have to push this out a little bit. Because I still want it to be three wide. Maybe I can build the supports along here. I could even go over here and just say that part of it broke. So there's, like, a narrow ledge here. Ooh, that would actually be really cool. I'm going to do that. Good idea. All right, this gives us the requisite three wide path that we want to work with. And we need to go up faster than this. I'm worried. Right. Yeah, this isn't going up fast enough. Just gonna raise everything up by one right there, because this can kind of, yeah, I like that this is all narrow here. It looks like a part of it might have fell. I'll have to work with that, but this is all gonna make it so this can go up not as steep of an angle. Actually, I'm happy that I'm showing this, because it's almost too esoteric whenever you see someone building. And it's like, okay, I'm done. This is it. You don't really see the grinding, the process of building it. Because nothing really just like builds itself usually, unless you're just like so used to building that you're that good. Usually, it takes a little bit of weird trial and error, which is exactly what's going on here. In fact, I'm going to take away some of this. That's going to help smooth things out. And I wonder, should I take this out? Maybe. Yeah, I kind of like that. It gives more of a, ooh, more of that view. Nice, I like that. I'm going to keep, yeah. All right, so see, we slugged it out. Now, there's a path. And all it takes is a slugfest. Nice section there. And then switchback madness. Come down. And we're at the bottom. So let's see, how does this look? Does this look good? Oh, cool. I actually like that. It's kind of hard to see, which is kind of cool in itself. But it definitely tries to wind around in a natural way. Let's get a dirt pillar going here. And that should be enough. All right, so you can see the path. That I like that, actually. It looks like it's just like, ooh, just kind of, okay, there we go. Okay, there we go. That's my raw interpretation of the path. I also prefer kind of building it into the surroundings, because otherwise you just carve out a straight line that goes to the bottom. And like, maybe that looks good sometimes, but I think this kind of working with the nature instead of against it is something I rather enjoy doing, actually. All right, now it's time to make it make sense physics-wise. So down here, I'm looking at supports now, specifically supports. We have the paths, we need support. Stuff like this, it's straightforward enough. If there's dirt underneath brick, brick's not gonna have much support. And if there's nothing below brick, that's even less than dirt. So I'm gonna do, oops. Just gonna, you know, find those spots. And as just a blanket rule, just have it come down like that. Wherever there's anything like this, bring it all the way down until you can't see the dirt underneath it. And if you do that with everything, it goes from this to something like this. And that's just taking whatever the path was and just putting a support directly beneath it. I thought I saw a creeper over here. I'm losing my mind. The thing is, I stopped around there because that area is where I think things are going to be broken a little bit more. So let's head over there. But anyways, this section over here, let's take a look at it. Now I can get bringing these down so it looks like this. And when I do this, I'm also careful not to have any gaps so that mobs can spawn in them. All I need is just, you know, one spot and like they'll just, you know, be growling at you for the rest of your days as you walk by, and I really don't want that. But I liked the idea of having this be sort of broken, a little treacherous. So what I might do is actually have a little bit of this. So it's clear that this is a much more broken than, you know, it's not just like I accidentally made the path wide or not wide. So there's a little bit of stone down there. I capitalize on that there. But that's about all the capitalizing I can do. Let's see, I'm going to give myself a little something to stand on over here. Yeah, I might as well just get rid of this. That tells you what. I'll go down another layer. Anywhere we can get a good vantage point is it's nice to be able to do. I'm just going to put two blocks beneath everything. I think that'll do it. And I can even build in front of that. In fact, I'll do that. There. So it looks more broken out. I kind of like that. And for my final trick, let's get rid of this stuff. F1 time. All right, I can dig it. I can dig it. So we actually have a path. This is just a start. This might not even be what it looks like by the end, but it's something. If you're gonna do anything, you gotta start. And the first step to doing something well is to doing it crappily or very badly. So, not saying this is bad, I'm actually pretty happy with this. I might tweak it a little places. Just a little places, though. Another thing I might as well do, since I have a bunch of half slabs, is start throwing them in. Just kinda wherever I think they're probably necessary. Since this is an old path, it could even have like pieces missing. Like really, the half slabs will work as something, I don't know. As long as they're against the sides. Like you can skip this little corner here and you'll still run up it. And maybe you could even have some missing there. It's not perfect, but it doesn't have to be, something like this. Maybe make it a rule, you can only put two half slabs per elevation change. It'll force you to think strange. After you do that, you got yourself a pretty cool path. Check it out. I gotta kinda be careful as I show this off, even though I'm like spinning as I go down the path. This is not what you'd wanna do ever in real life. Probably die instantly. In fact, yeah, it would just be like you'd be instantly either dead or in a coma. So don't do that. There we go. And you know what? That's the castle even gets to look cool from here because of all the edge-tastic edginess going on. You probably barely see it in the video, but it's there. Oh, this is actually a cool spot to look at it because you have the statues, the path there. You can see the opening underneath, and the rest of the thing. So, there it is. Another episode. Boom! And this one was finally above ground. Just in time for the next one. It's probably going to be below ground. I guess it depends if I get the entirety of Cerebro done. Which I'd like to. Turns out it takes a while to hunt down all the quartz necessary and replace the blocks. So that's turning into a bigger project than like, might as well be straight with y'all, with you all, y'all, is that that takes a while. Big projects take a while. This just in. Here's your news forecast for today and for the rest of your life. But that's no reason not to do any of these things, you know. Might have a big project on the horizon, you think, oh, that's a lot of work. But, life's a big project. So there's my 2-bit wisdom for you. Take it or leave it. But anyways, this has been RedMcNed in the Saga. Hope you've enjoyed it. And if you want, stick around. There's more to come. Lots more. There better be anyway.